Hey, Internet friends, this is Magic Brad with the Magic Brad Show, and I've got a guest on. I'm going to bring him on. His name is James, and the last name is Zolman. He's got a pretty interesting business because I'm one of those people that like to outsource the technical tasks to someone else, so it's going to be fun. I'm going to bring James on right now, and here he is, ladies and gentlemen, boys and berries. There he is, James. How are you?
Hey, Brad. I'm doing great. How are you?
Wonderful, wonderful. What part of the world are you in?
I'm in Idaho.
Idaho, there's potatoes out there.
Lots of potatoes, absolutely. I love it. I love potatoes. I eat them several times a week.
My wife is a potato fan. She likes mashed potatoes and gravy with a lot of butter on it.
There you go. Yeah, those are. So,
How long have you lived there?
So I'm roughly 17 years. My wife was born and raised here, and we love the summers. I finally got into winter sports just a few years ago, so it took me maybe 14 years to get into winter sports, but I did because the winters are long up here.
Okay, well,
I love it. I love it,
Minnesota.
Oh yeah, you've got long winters too. Then
you've got winters. It's not as bad as people think it is, though. It's Minnesota. It's so terrible. I remember once I did an event here, and we had the international group for Meeting Professionals International. They came in like July or August. They all brought jackets and stuff because they're from international and they know about Minnesota. And oh my God, it's going to be so cold. And it's like 90 degrees and they got jackets on.
That's funny.
So you got kids and stuff
out there. What's that?
You got the kids and stuff? Kids?
Oh yeah. 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 We've got three kids. They are 8, 11, and 13. And they're an absolute blast. I love this age range right now. We're going into the teenage years though. So I'm a little bit nervous, but, we'll see. Right. We'll see how they end up by the time they're 18 or 20.
They start getting that independence, and you got to kind of deal with it.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
I don't have any kids myself, but I've been a spectator.
Oh, there you go.
So let's talk a little bit about your business. I'm going to do this little banner thing. This is really cool, the StreamYard platform that I'm using. It's kind of cool. So here we are.
Yeah, I like this so far. This is my first time using StreamYard, so thanks for having me here, Brad. This is wonderful. I love it.
So there's the domain name of
GruntWorkers.com.
Company, GruntWorkers. I don't know if I like that name, Grunt, but that's okay. Yeah. If we're outsourcing it to you, you could be the grunt worker.
Yep. We are the grunt workers. That's right. Yeah, I got the name. Of course, there's the military grunt, and high finance also has grunt workers. And the guys in the grunt workers war rooms in high finance, those are your analysts. They're doing all of the research. They're doing all of the grunt work of the finance world on these floors at Goldman Sachs and these other places. And I decided I would use that same term, but for marketing, because marketing online, there's a ton of groundwork that has to be done. Now, you mentioned outsourcing the tech work. I love to do that. I have plenty of contacts. If you ever need tech work, I can refer you to some good people, but we strictly do marketing. We don't do any of the tech work. We don't do any development. We don't do any website programming or anything like that.
But even so, you're a younger generation. I'm 63. I don't know. Are you like in the 40s, maybe?
Yeah, pretty close. I'm getting there. But yeah, not quite yet.
Psychotic. I read your mind.
Yes.
Because people that are around it all the time, like just like any new program, I just noticed, what the heck was it? I was on something. I use Kartra. And they just...
Oh, yeah. Kartra's awesome. I love
it. They put something new in there. If you're not on it all the time, you got to read stuff.
Yeah.
Whereas as a grunt worker, you guys are on it. Even the techie stuff, you can kind of quantum leap all that kind of stuff. Because I know that, you know, as business owners, we're supposed to be taking care of our customers, not working on, you know, how do you create this tracking link so that you can know how many hits came on a Facebook ad.
Pulling the levers and dealing with all of the settings. Yep. Yeah, absolutely. You're a professional at what you do. And so our audience, though, it's kind of unique. Our audience, we strictly serve digital marketers and people with a digital marketing background. And the reason we do that is because agencies provide the strategy, those consultants and those strategists that you can hire as an entrepreneur or a specialist in your field, those guys have the strategy. We literally do the grunt work. The strategy is the high level. It's the expensive stuff. It's the stuff that will make you money. And then grunt workers are the guys behind the scenes pulling all the levers based on that strategy. So that's why we work with strictly with digital marketers, whether it's an agency or a consultant or a freelancer, because they hand us the strategy and we just go to town, and it helps helps everybody save money. It helps digital marketers be able to scale their business, because a lot of times what we see these days, and there's a transition happening, but normally what we see is they'll create the strategy and then they'll build it. And they use all of this time to do that when they could be creating more strategies and helping guys like you, Brad, launch a lot more campaigns if they have somebody like us in their back office or in their back pocket, so to speak, to say, okay, I'm creating for Brad, I'm creating 10 strategies this time instead of one. Because usually I'll do one at a time, knock it out for Brad, and then work on the next one. But with GRUNTWORKERS, I can spin up 10, hand it off to GRUNTWORKERS, they can get them all done, and then I have 10 awesome tests going on, and the chances are one or two or three will be winners.
So we'll give an example of what a grunt worker, what is their tasks? Do they specialize in, I'm a grunt worker for doing Facebook stuff?
Yeah, exactly. So Facebook ads, Google ads. Google owns YouTube, so that includes YouTube ads. Facebook owns Instagram, so that includes Instagram ads.
Good deal for a business owner in that it changes. I know somebody that they're kind of like a Mari Smith that's local here. Facebook.
Awesome.
She's on Facebook, so she knows the latest thing that came out this morning.
Perfect.
And me, as a business owner, I don't want to jack with that kind of stuff. It's crazy when all of a sudden Facebook just put this button that was over here, it's now down here. I'm going, where's the button? Oh, there it is. Sure. Makes me crazy. But you're talking like your grunt workers, they know that because they got their finger on the pulse of it all the time.
Yep, they're always in there. And it drives people nuts that each one of these platforms, they have thousands of different settings. And you can get in and try to change them all, and then the next day they'll be gone, or they'll be moved, or they'll be nested inside of something else. And yeah, these platforms have just gotten so convoluted. They're easy to use on the outset, and you can DIY to a certain extent. But once you get a little bit deeper into it, you'll find that it's mind-blowing.
No, I don't even change the oil in my car anymore. That's taking out a plug and putting new oil in it. I don't even do that because it's not the same as it used to be when I was a kid.
Yeah.
So with, oil change. You say that you'd primarily focus on digital marketers. Isn't that also like a bigger company, say locally here, we've got Valley Fair Amusement Park. They've got a division that does the marketing, and part of those are digital marketers. You help those digital marketers do their jobs, they get more group sales into Valley Fair?
Yes, exactly. Yeah. So a digital marketer, that they can be in any role. They can be freelancer, the agency owner, to in-house. With the age of the internet these days, I've been a CMO in all of my partnerships for the last decade. So CMOs can have a very deep digital background or be similar to me and understand and be able to spin out digital strategy as well. So yeah, in-house digital marketers, digital marketing strategists, digital marketing managers, Facebook ads managers in-house for companies like that. Absolutely. Those are the guys that are hiring us.
Well, that sounds pretty interesting. I was going through your website and stuff, and it kind of intrigued me because, you know, I'm, like I said, I can do 90% of it, and then the other 10% is a missing cog. And if you've got a transmission in a car and there's one gear that's missing, they ain't gonna turn the wheels, you know?
Yep.
And that's frustrating with me because I'm building something out and I'm thinking, really cool, I'm gonna do this Google ad for this specific YouTube video. And then I get to a place where I can't comprehend what it is, because I don't speak that language. And it gets pretty frustrating. And it's like, you know what? I'm just going to go back to place and add in the yellow pages.
There you go. Yeah. Yep. No, I totally get it. Yeah. Yeah. It's a lot of fun. We love helping digital marketers, especially those who are helping small businesses and other entrepreneurs get the exposure that they need. So yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's definitely a very niche company, but that niche, the digital marketer world, for how many digital marketers there are worldwide, internationally, it's surprisingly big. So we have a lot of fun.
Well, it's interesting. You've got a niche, but it's not really a like an industry niche. Is there any specific industry you work in with chiropractors, dentists, real estate agents, or anything like that? Or is it across the board, anybody that needs something done?
No, because we can adopt the strategy. It is understanding that marketing software, that marketing technology, so to speak, non-development wise, right? So like you said, and like we were talking about just a couple minutes ago, Facebook ads has thousands of checkboxes and options and audiences and more. So you can look at any industry, and if the strategy is handed to you, you can match it up and do the grunt work of piecing it all together and making sure that you're targeting the right audience with the right advertising and messaging and so on. So yeah, we're sort of a bolt-on staff that way to any digital marketing guru, so to speak, who is targeting those niches. So chiropractors to auto mechanic shops to whatever, right? Amusement parks. So some guys specialize just in travel websites and entertainment websites and others. So yeah, we serve all of them. So our niche really is strictly digital marketers. So it is a niche, but they can be very broad.
It's sort of a skill set niche.
Yeah. Yeah. Knowing the platforms inside and out.
Subject matter
experts in the platform.
This has kind of got me excited because I do like to automate and delegate. I don't like working.
Hey, I do too. That's why I built it, to help all these digital marketers do that. That's exactly, those are the exactly right words to use.
Let me give you some more plug here. There it is, GruntWorkers.
Oh, thank you.
And if you're interested in it, maybe there's something we could do as a little mini series or something and start going into some pillars. Because my background is in the event industry. And when the COVID mm-hmm. thing happened, guess what happened to the event industry?
Everything canceled. Yeah. Yeah. I have a lot of friends in that space, public speaking guys and authors. And they
so a lot of these guys need to move online.
Yep.
And so I'm saying that maybe we could do a series or something like using grunt workers for the catering industry, using grunt workers for the inflatable activity industry, using grunt works for group sales in theaters, using grunt workers for, you know, tent rentals and linen rentals and chairs. And, you know, maybe we could do a couple different things and then I could put it out to my specific industry, because I feel for them. A lot of these guys, yeah. They got big companies. I'm a small guy. I'm an owner operator. So I was able to pivot in this situation.
Oh, great.
These guys That's got good. A big ship going forward. They're not able to pivot and they're having a hard time. You heard the Mall of America struggling.
Yes.
Yeah. How do you pivot something like that? It's huge. So
yeah,
those type of people need some help like this, because otherwise they have to retrain their entire people and they can't even come to work. They have to work from home. Whereas you kind of have a turnkey system. You can just say, you put together the strategy, we'll put together the marketing, and you can get back to serving the client.
Yeah, yeah. As long as we're working with a digital marketer, I'm definitely open to discussing that. Yeah, let's definitely take a look at it.
Shall we? Okay, sounds cool. This is pretty interesting. Yeah. Because when I saw your website, y'all all of a sudden have that aha.
Hey. Sure.
I just ran into another guy this morning. I've got a meeting after this one that he's got a thing going on. You know, all those Yelp ads, you know, you got the you know, 2 stars versus 5 stars.
Yep.
When you got 2 stars, you want to talk to that person and say, why did you give us 2 stars? The 5 stars.
Yeah, we can fix that. Reputation management. Yeah. Yeah. Yep.
He's got a little program like that. It looks intriguing to me. And it's interesting because where I pivoted from this event industry into this affiliate marketing world.
Yes.
Whole nother
affiliate marketing.
It's amazing what's happening right now. And I just want to keep the ball rolling rather than throwing in the towel.
Absolutely. What are you marketing as an affiliate? If you don't mind me asking.
I'm doing affiliate tools.
Okay.
Like cool. Yourself.
Okay.
And education, because a lot of people don't get this kind of thing. And unfortunately, they go out and they, you know, you can't just go to college and learn this kind of thing. It's expensive.
Sure.
And if you just go on to, you know, YouTube University and try and find it, you're going to get a bunch of misinformation.
Yeah, it can be old or outdated. Yep.
Totally old and outdated. I mean, and I like to simplify things as much as I can. To me, the whole marketing thing is 3 things. Plant the seed, nurture the plant, harvest the fruit. That's all it really is. It's generate the lead, build the relationship, and then close the sale. It's as simple as that. But like I've mentioned to a lot of people, if you're marketing, you know, barbecues and hamburgers and steaks, and you're reaching vegetarians and vegans, guess what? It's not going to work.
Yeah.
You got to have that.
That's a good contrast. I like that. That's funny.
Yeah. And I think a lot of people are doing that. They're trying to sell things to people that don't want it.
Sure. And Yeah. Your audience has to be right for your product. Absolutely. There has to be a product market fit, right?
That's what it is. Product market fit. Some people don't understand it because it's complicated, but it's basically, here's your merchant and here's your guy that wants to buy it. You got to make a relationship and then it's done. Keep it simple. It's fairly simple.
Yep. I agree. So,
how do we get a hold of you other than your website? We've got grunt workers on there.
Thank you. You're more than welcome to visit the website, gruntworkers.com. You can also find me on LinkedIn. Just look for James Zolman on LinkedIn. I really love LinkedIn. I've been leveraging that a lot more lately. I'm happy to connect with anybody there. And that's primarily what I'm using these days. You can also email me, james.zolman@gruntworkers.com. That'll get right to me. Those are the primary ways to get a hold of me these days.
That's kind of how I've done it. I've simplified it myself with this. contactmagicbrad.com.
Yeah, I like that.
Page that has how to get a hold of me. So when people say, how do I get a hold of you? You just go to contactmagicbrad.com. I don't have to say, go to brad@synergyeventmarketing.com. It's just simple. Contact Magic Brad.
I like it.
Okay, James, I'm going to sign this off, beam it up to the universe. And
It was a pleasure chatting with you, Brad. Thank you so much for having me.
Wonderful.
This was a lot of fun.
Thank you, sir.
I enjoyed the conversation.
Okay, peace.
We'll see you.
Thank you.